درست ایک فنکشن کال ہیڈ ہیئر یو کین پاس سپوز آئی سے n از ایکول ٹو 3 دس ول گیو می فرسٹ 3 روز آف یور ڈیٹا فریم If I say n is equal to 2, it will give me first 2 rows of the data frame. If I just say df.head and I do not pass any value of n, it gives me the entire data frame. Now there are some operations that we can perform on this. Let's say so this gives me an array with only unique elements from this. The duplicates are not included basically.
Okay.
In this column.
It only applies to a vector, right? I mean a single column or single row.
You can also find out how many unique elements are there by using this length function. So one way of finding out the number of unique elements is this length function.
Okay.
The other one is using the n unique function. Then there's one more function called unique count. So this will basically tell you how many times each of these values have occurred. Each of these unique values. If so, 22 occurred 2 times, 11, 1, 6. Gives you a series. You can use your conditional selection here as well.
Yeah, sure.
you can have apply your conditional selection here. Now you can also pass these elements of a column to a function. So let's say I have a function. Okay. Now I want to pass certain columns or elements of all elements of a particular column to this function. Okay. There's an apply function which you can use. Let's say df of, let's say column 1. Dot apply and the name of the function. So the value was 1, 2, 3, 4 and now it became 2, 4, 6, 8 because this multiplied. So I'm passing all the values of this column to this function.
Okay. But why do you print out the print in 1, 2, 0, 1,
2, 3? So 0, 1, 2 are the indexes.
Oh, indexes. Oh, okay. Oh, so always you need to use this apply.
Yeah, whenever you're working with function, you need to use this apply. It's a function. Apply is also a function.
So can you use the apply function for a 2D also? Because here it's typically 1D.
Yeah, you can use it.
For 2D also, right?
In fact, you can also use it for built-in functions. Okay. So this gives me length of each string present in this column 3.
Okay, that's actually interesting.
So using 2D, then your function should have two arguments. Should be able to take two arguments.